In the previous video, we discovered a device with the SAU and it became available to have its configuration changed. Just how are we connected to that device, making it possible to control it remotely? In this particular case, both the computer running the SAU and the CR1 are set to DHCP and connected to a switch. There's no DHCP server in place here, and as such, they have received link local addresses and so are able to communicate with each other. This type of communication could also be a possibility by simply connecting a computer's network port directly to the CR1's network port. You can see the device's address and the computer's address here in the SAU. Since I'm connected through a switch, it's possible that I can communicate with more than one device at a time. And I've gone ahead and set up a system just like this, adding a second device to the switch. Now, if I go back to the SAU and click refresh, we can see that the second device has appeared. It looks a little different, though, than this device we've been working with. The status indicators are all dark, and if we select it, we see the properties window is not available. It's clear that the state of this connection is not the same across these two devices. Just what may be going on here? Let's take a closer look. Just as before, my computer and this device on the left are set to DHCP and communicating. This is the device as showing as available in the SAU. And this new one is showing as grayed out. We know from the SAU that this device is at this IP address. The SAU cannot configure or actively monitor devices outside of its own subnet, but using its built-in MDNS capability, it can be aware of those devices. If I change the network settings of the computer running the SAU to be on the same subnet as this new CR1, once I go back to the software, I'll see that new device appears available to monitor and configure. My first device is located out there, but it's no longer available. All control and configuration options are grayed out. You can see my computer and the second device are now on the same subnet. Once again, here's the setup prior to changing our computer's IP address. And here it is after making the change. Another case where a device may show up as grayed out in the SAU would be if the wrong password is entered. The SAU has a single password field and the option to connect to your entire subnet's worth of Devio devices. This means that if you have 50 devices on your subnet and you gave them all the same password, you can view and administer all 50 at once. If they all had unique passwords, you would only have access to make changes to one at a time. To demonstrate this, I've put two Devios on the same subnet as my computer, configured them with identical passwords, and entered that password into the SAU, where they are both showing as available, as you can see here. I'm going to go ahead and change the password to the device named My First Devio. Its connection status will change here in the SAU. If I go up to the password field and type in the new password, My First Devio will reappear as available, but My Second Devio's status will change. It is now grayed out. So, device availability in the SAU relies on the existence of a valid network path between your computer and the device, selecting the correct network adapter on your computer for the SAU to communicate through, the password assigned to the individual Devio device, and the password specified in the SAU's password field. There's one final reason why a device may appear as grayed out, and it's not strictly related to the device discovery process, but rather to the SAU. Namely, an instance of the SAU will remember any device you have previously connected to until you remove it from the device list. For example, in the little Devio network we were just working on, if I were to permanently relocate this device, making it inaccessible to this computer. The next time I performed a device discovery on this network, my SAU would look like this. A device at that IP address is remembered, but we both know I have physically removed it from the network. Use the SAU's remove button to delete it from the device list. The SAU help file, as well as access to the SAU software itself, is located at devio-help.biamp.com. And as always, the Biamp support website is always being updated with useful information.